Sometimes we'll need to classify costs as either product or period costs. This is also referred to as manufacturing or non-manufacturing costs. A product cost includes any cost that is required to purchase or manufacture inventories. For a retailer, this would simply be the cost of buying the inventory. So a retailer of office furniture might buy desks and resell them. If they buy that desk for $150, that's the product cost of the desk. For a manufacturer, this would include any cost required to manufacture that desk. So that would be wood, someone to assemble the wood, and a place for this work to take place, and some equipment, and some tools like saws. So when we think about a manufacturer, there are three broad categories of product costs: direct material, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. We'll talk about each of these in turn. Now, direct material becomes an integral part of the finished product, and the cost can be traced conveniently to that product. So wood for a desk manufacturer would be a direct material. I will abbreviate this as DM from time to time throughout the course. Direct material can be natural resources such as wood, or it can simply be a part that is purchased from another company. If the manufacturer of elliptical machines purchases motors for those machines, then that would be a direct material. For a t-shirt manufacturer, fabric would be an example of a direct material. It is important to note that the term raw material refers to both direct and indirect material. You will find, as we move through the course, it is important to distinguish between direct and indirect material. Direct labor. This is the labor cost that can be easily traced to individual units. Sometimes it's called touch labor because they work hands on the product. From time to time throughout the course, I will abbreviate this as DL. This would be bottlers at Coca-Cola Company, or for a t-shirt manufacturer, this would be the sewing machine operators. Now, factory labor includes both direct and indirect labor as well. And you'll see later in the course that it is important to distinguish between these two. Manufacturing overhead includes all other manufacturing costs, so it's an interesting way to define it. First, it has to be a manufacturing cost, and second, it's not direct material or direct labor, so it's everything else. These cannot be easily traced to the specific units. They're often called indirect manufacturing cost, factory overhead, or factory burden. I will abbreviate this as OH or occasionally MOH, but I'm talking about manufacturing overhead. When we think of overhead, we need to get the idea that this would include indirect material. So while it is a material, if you can't trace it easily to each unit, then you will classify it as an overhead cost. This becomes important later when we start to try to identify how to assign cost to inventory. Sometimes indirect material is called factory supplies. For a t-shirt manufacturer, this might include thread. If you don't want to trace that to each unit, then it would be an indirect material. Oil for the sewing machines would be almost impossible to trace to each t-shirt. Scissors, thimbles, other small tools would be considered an indirect material for a t-shirt manufacturer. Manufacturing overhead also includes indirect labor. Indirect labor is factory labor, but it is difficult to trace it to each unit. For a t-shirt manufacturer, this would include the factory supervisor's salary. The factory supervisor is going to work in the factory, but they're not going to have a specific job on each unit that is produced. They're going to oversee scheduling and the general operations of the factory. The factory janitors would be included here. They're needed in the factory, but they do not work hands on the product. Other examples of overhead include maintenance and repairs on production equipment, heat, light, and power, property taxes, depreciation, insurance, etc. But this needs to be on manufacturing facilities, on your manufacturing plant, that is. You can think of this in terms of being facilities costs, just the cost of owning machinery or a warehouse or a manufacturing plant. So when you think of overhead, this is for a t-shirt manufacturer, think of it in terms of this would include indirect material, indirect labor, like the factory janitor, the factory supervisor, or security personnel. And then it would include the cost of renting a space to manufacture the products, or maintaining the plant, or maintaining the equipment. Providing heat, light, and power to that facility. Those are the other overhead costs. How do we treat product costs? Think back to your first accounting course. When you bought inventory, you didn't put it in cost of goods sold immediately. You recorded it as an asset called inventory. When the goods were sold, then you expensed it through cost of goods sold on the income statement. So it's first an asset and is an expense when sold. And that, of course, accommodates the matching principle. Period costs. These are non-manufacturing costs. Selling and administrative costs are what we're talking about here. They're often called operating expenses. All of these terms are synonymous. Period cost, operating expenses, selling and administrative costs. They will include selling costs. Anything to secure the customer order and get the finished product to the customer. So examples would be sales salaries and commissions, travel expenses, salesman's auto expenses, delivery to customers, marketing and advertising. You will also have administrative costs. This would be your executives and your clerical workers, just the general management of the organization. So administrative salaries, clerical wages, research and development expenses would fall in under administrative costs. But it also includes things like rent, insurance, depreciation, property taxes, utilities, maintenance, etc. You've heard these costs before, but now, if they're on selling and administrative facilities, they will be a period cost. So now when you hear that rent cost was incurred, you will have to ask yourself, rent on what? Before you'll know how to classify it as a product or a period cost. Period costs are treated very differently from product costs. They're expensed in the period incurred. They are not recorded as an asset and expensed when goods are sold. They're expensed immediately. Now, there are a few caveats like prepaid rent or depreciation, but in general, they are expensed in full in the period incurred. Now, this product versus period distinction is necessary in order to prepare financial statements. We will spend some time on how we do that in this course, but understand that this is critical for a company to do in order to prepare an income statement and balance sheet. Two additional terms, prime costs, that refers to direct material plus direct labor. That term was coined at the turn of the century when the primary cost of production were materials and labor. But now, of course, overhead has become a major cost of production with automation. We have more costs that are going into equipment and maintaining and operating and powering that equipment. But the term prime has stuck. So that is direct material plus direct labor. Conversion costs, that would be direct labor and overhead, the cost of converting materials. Let's do a short activity to see if you have understood these terms. Classify the following costs incurred by able furniture manufacturers using the following choices. DM for direct material, DL for direct labor, OH for manufacturing overhead, or P for period cost. Lumber used in production. Since this is a manufacturer of furniture, we can assume lumber would be a direct cost of production, and we'll call that direct material. Insurance on building used to house the manufacturing plant. All right, so this is a facilities cost. Notice that it is on the manufacturing plant. So this would be overhead. Had that been on administrative offices, it would have been a period cost. Wages paid to carpenters. We can assume those are the people who assemble the furniture, and that would be direct labor. Rent paid on administrative headquarters. This is a facilities cost, and it's on your selling and administrative facilities, so we'll call that a period cost. Depreciation on computers used by sales office clerks. That would be a selling cost, so it will be classified as period. Glue and sandpaper required in production. Well, that is a product cost because it is required in production, but in all likelihood, we would not trace how much sandpaper is needed to produce one desk. And we probably would not trace glue to each desk. So while it is a product cost, it is not direct material, it is not direct labor, so it would be classified as manufacturing overhead. Now stay tuned, we will talk a little more about cost classifications and we'll work a more comprehensive example to make sure you understand these important concepts.